In today's episode, let's review Cycle Brand's Rahasyamayi Agarbatti. Namaste everyone, and welcome to Om Incense Show with DJ, a show that helps you increase your incense quotient. So if you are an incense enthusiast, consider subscribing. So today let's do this video review, which is a requested review, and this review was requested by Vidvatanji. So this review is for Vidvatanji and for all of us here. And before we go ahead, I'd like to remind you of this Meri Pratham Sanskrit Pustika. Link is in the description box below. So let's do this. And if you're here for the first time, I'd just like you to know that we first discuss the packaging and then the fragrance of the incense. Then we discuss an incense tidbit. And in the end, we have answer to the previous quiz and a new quiz. So you might want to stay till the last bit here. This is a long agarbatti, like the Pushkarini one. So this is a long one and it comes like that. So on one side we have this nice Rahasyamayi written in English, and it says celebration incense sticks Durva, Sol, Bhupali, Sol Veda. So those are the four things written here. If you can see that's what we have. And then we have pictures of a dancer, a mother and a daughter, and again a child celebrating her birthday. And it says four fragrances in one stick. So that's what we have. This is what we have here. That's on one side. Then on the other side, we have the Cycle Brand logo, the NR Ranga Rao and Sons logo, and manufacturing address and consumer complaints numbers and all those stuff. Content says handcrafted agarbattis plus free agarbatti holder, net quantity 4N, so 4 incense sticks we have and 1 agarbatti holder we have, and this is for 40 rupees, and they've given the the web address and all those things. So this is what we have. So if you see that, so that's what we have on one side. Then we have the branding in Hindi. So it says Rahasyamayi, Durva, Sol, Bhupali, Sol Veda, and it says last 3 hours. Agarbatti when lit lasts for about 180 minutes. This pack contains 4 sticks, and then we have directions. Then we have the barcode, the carbon neutral logo, the green earth logo, the responsible care logo, and the we have a scanning code, and then we have a barcode. So that's what we have on the other side. That's what we have. And then on one side, then what we have is the picture of the agarbatti holder, and then 4 fragrances. It has shown a large, a long fragrance stick. So in one fragrance we have in one stick we have 4 fragrances. So I don't think it'll be possible for me to review the whole thing, because it'll take 180 minutes. And so if you see, the incense is divided into 4 parts, and each part has a different fragrance. If you see that, then we have the holder. What I'll do is I'll light up the stick and we'll see the initial fragrance. So probably the initial one is Sol Veda, and then next to it is Bhupali, next to it is Sol, and the last one is Durva. So probably I'll only be doing the Sol Veda stuff, the one that's in the beginning. You see that? So that's what I'll do. So that is about the packaging. On one side we have the Cycle Brand logo again, and the Cycle Brand logo on the other side also. That's what we have here. Now let's open the box and see. If you open the box, this is what, this is what it comes out like. Oh, it's nice and pink. So we have a cardboard like stuff to hold the incense in place and safe. My god, nice fragrance. So You know, inside we have this branded plastic pouch, and we have two pouches like that, and two sticks in each, so we have four sticks like that. I'd wanted to take this home. This time when I'd gone home, I'd gone to my in-laws' house, and I'd wanted to take this, you know, for them for the Durga Puja, which is coming up next month. But because I did not get the time to shoot this, so I could not take it. I'll probably get them delivered, you know, get these delivered to them somehow. Let's see. So this is what we have. And if you see the incense, it's nice because it says the celebrations, something, you know, it said about celebrations. It says celebration incense sticks. So that's what, you know, they've tried to depict through the picture, the color of the incense. So if you, oh, it actually, this smelled like an ice cream to me. It's a mixture of ice cream and bubblegum. I'm sorry guys, you know, I'm sorry if I'm going off track, but by now you know that, you know, that's the kind of sense of smell I have. So this is what we have. It's that big. What if I shoot my hands? It's like almost that big, you see, like that. Really, this smells like bubblegum and a mixture of bubblegum and ice cream, and it's all pink. So, you know, it's, you know, when you smell this, you actually get different. Yes, you do get different fragrances from different parts of the stick. So this is that sweet bubblegummy ice creamy smell. This is that cologne kind of smell, that cologne. You know, the ones that we use on our body, the cologne. So that's the cologne, not colon, cologne. I didn't like this one. This is that. Oh, the little dirty, the little fragrant. What fragrance is it? You know, the fragrance of an eraser. If you've ever smelled the fragrance of an eraser, or you know, the kids have those erasers. The last one is what? This is some kind of sweet smell. So overall, it's a sweet smell, you know. You know, you get that. Except for this cologne one, which is like really fresh and cologne-y. I somehow don't like that kind of fragrance in incense sticks. You know, I've tested so many incenses now, and I think the best things that, you know, the best ones I like are the masala sticks. Oh yes, and so it is like, it doesn't have any kind of powder or anything on top of it. It's just like that. And it has nice, this bamboo thing, this core is nice and thick and, you know, rounded. If you see that, it's nice and thick that way. Let's check out the incense holder. The incense holder, I'm sure, must be the same like they had in Pushkarani. There. Dirty. I don't like this. Doesn't matter, I'll anyway not keep it plain, you know, I'll be painting it. So last time also I had shown this to you, and I said I'll be painting it in white and gold, so that's what I'll do with this also. So that's what we have. Okay, and let's check this. This is very much like, you know, if I remember when we were young kids, you know, in the school, and the sisters used to hit us with this, something like that. Oh, I don't feel like wasting this. This is so much like a mashal. The torch. This is sweet kind of smell, you know, I've smelled this kind of smell somewhere in some temple, I don't remember where, but And that smell of burnt wood. So this is the Soul Veda one, the front portion of it. But overall, I somehow these smells do not appear natural to me. I think probably I'm very stuck to the real natural stuff. So I like smell like Gugal and Loban and Kapoor and Chandan and stuff. So I don't like these mixed fragrances. And mixed fragrances as in these are compounds. So if the fragrance is called Soul Veda, of course they'll have a mixture of too many stuff, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and then you come up with a fragrance and that's what they've named. Because if it was purely Chandan, they would just call it Chandan and Loban and stuff, Gugal and stuff, but this is like Soul Veda and Bhupali and Soul and Durva. So I'm sure these are all compounds of various fragrances, and I'm not really a big fan of these. I don't know if any of you have used it, just let me know, because you might probably like it. Like I've told you earlier also, the sense of smell is a very subjective thing. So you might not like what I like, and I might not be a big fan of whatever your favorite fragrance is. So I don't like the compounds as in, because I don't like the something that comes across as cosmo or artificial. The smell of something natural is what I like more. So I can associate more with them. So those are the kind of fragrances I like. But if you're somebody who do like compounds and who like different fragrances and mixed up fragrances, blends, if you like, then probably you like it. And overall, if you like a sweet fragrance, then you like this. So it's a good thing. And like this at the celebration incense stick. So if you want it, I think this is otherwise a good option for having it in your house while seriously. So like they've shown it in the thing. So if there's a birthday going on, and just place it in the balcony or your garden or somewhere, probably in a corner of a house where nobody is able to come near it, and you can just get the smell of it. And the smell is medium, as in the intensity wise it's medium, so it's neither very subtle nor very strong. So it's the kind of fragrance that you'll get to know once you enter the room, and you're there for a time, you'll get to know this. So that's the kind of thing that we have. But this definitely has a temple kind of feel, because I've smelled this somewhere in some temple, and if you go to the temples, you might probably find this fragrance familiar. So that's what this. And yes, you can use it for your shadi, your party, or somewhere, a havan in your house, or Durga Puja, or something where you want a large, a long stick which will go on for a long time. Like they said, 180 minutes, they're saying. So this will be a good thing for that. And so that's what I think about this. And I like the color of it. I like the pink color. It's that nice pink color. So that's what we have. Okay, now the incense, just one second, huh? Oh, see? Can you see that? So I tapped away the ash from the top, and it's a nice thick one, it's a nice thick thing. See? Like that? Nice and thick. See that? That's the reason that it'll go on for long. It has quite a few layers inside it. So that's what we have. Oh, it's sad. I'll be shooting the Hindi thing right now, and I should have kept this for it. But anyway, chalo. So that's what the fragrance was, and so that's what Rahasyamayi for you is. And so now time for the incense tidbit today. So all of us have heard of Sholashang Dhoop, but very few of us know that Sholashang Dhoop is different for different books. So like some books will have a different set of 16 ingredients which are known as Sholashang Dhoop, and the other texts will have different set of 16 ingredients which are known as Sholashang Dhoop. So what I'll do is in the coming episodes, I'll be letting you know of those different types of Shodha Shang Dhoop. So the set of 16 ingredients that constitute a dhoop. So that's what I'll be telling you in the coming episodes. For now, I just wanted you to know that Shodha Shang Dhoop is not a standard thing. Because when we start on this path and we come across this Shodha Shang Dhoop, it comes across as very fascinating, and we all want to know what the ingredients are. So actually the ingredients are nothing which is like, you know, it's not compartmentalized into a hard set of this and this and this. It basically differs from region to region and culture to culture. Like, you know, in India, we are a land of various cultures, so this differs from culture to culture. I have found a few written accounts of these 16 ingredients, and I'll be sharing them with you in the upcoming episodes. So that's what we'll do. And we also have different kind of dhoop. So in the various Puranas and Vedas that we have, so Agni Puran has a set of 21 ingredients which are known as dhoop. So I'll be telling you about them. And then we have Kalika Puran, which is very famous, and it has quite a few incense formulae, you know, the ancient ones. So that's what we'll do. And I'll be telling them to you all about those different sets in different episodes. So that's what we'll do. And besides that, what we have is we have a different set of ancient formulae in different books, and I'll be sharing them with you in the upcoming episodes as well. So that is the incense tidbit that I wanted to share with you today. And so the quiz that we had asked in the last episode was, what is the Latin name for Google? And Vidvatamji, Christine, do let me know if I need to call you G, because I don't know, I'm not sure if you like it. So Vidvatamji, Christine, Sushmita, my sister, and my friend Prashant. So these are the people who answered it, and they said Commiphora Mukul, and someone said Commiphora Whitey. They're both right, because different species are known as different things, like how we have four kinds of frankincense. So like we have different species of frankincense, frankincense sacra and Carteri and stuff, that in that the same way we also have different kind of Google from different species. So Commiphora Mukul or Commiphora Whitey would be right. So that was the answer to the last quiz. Now today's quiz: name one incense brand which has the name of a vehicle in it. An incense brand that has the name of a vehicle in it. So that's the quiz for today. And so that's all for the episode. And if you think somebody can learn something from this, share it with them. If you liked it, give it a like. And if you have any query, just write in the comment section below. And that's all for this episode. Till we meet again next, take very good care of yourself. Namaste.